right, the card is dried. The last step is adding our sentiment. So I just have a Merry Christmas sentiment here that clearly doesn't want to stick to my block. There we go. So Versamark ink, same ink we've been using throughout the class. And I'm going to stamp. And then we're going to emboss it with white powder. Same as before, if you get some powder where you don't want it, use a soft brush to brush it off. And it has to be done before embossing. The embossing is going to melt the powder. So if you've got powder where you don't want it, that heat gun is just going to heat it in place. Let's heat it. And always heat with the heat gun away from your fingers. That heat gun gets a little bit warm, so you don't want to be pointing it towards yourself because it starts to not feel good after a while. All right, it was slightly crooked on there, so I'm going to straighten it a little bit. And this part you could do after you've colored it. There we go. So now we're going to use that same color Copic marker that we used to color in the poinsettia, and I'm going to color the embossing powder. Now this is why it has to be done on black, because that black won't show the color you've been coloring with. But it's a great way to just add a custom sentiment in a perfect color to match your card. And then you could glue it flat to it. I chose to pop it up, so grab some pop dots, put them on the back of your sentiment there. Just adds a little bit of extra dimension. And just like the butterfly one, we only had two layers with this one, the back of the card plus the front, because it didn't really need more layers. But there we go, another stained glass card, but without having matching dies. But you can totally see through it.